Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come humbly as we know how. We come, Lord God, with uplifted hands and a surrendered heart. We surrender to you this morning, oh God. Oh Heavenly Father, we ask in the name of Jesus that you will look down on us, that you will have mercy upon us this morning.
Stop. lift their hands and bless Him.
Yeah.
gonna get our way out. Amen. Hallelujah. And she comes to your front. Amen. On the first offering, we have our Cash App. That's $Light401. Again, that's Cash App. That's $Light401. We also have our PayPal. That's www.paypal.me/LOTW Church. Again, that's www.paypal.me/LOTW Church. We also have Tithe. It's an app, I believe. And it's tithe.ly. Again, that's Tithe, tithe.ly. You can also mail in your ministry units to 4701 North 15th Street, Tampa, Florida 33610, as well as for our P.O. Box, that's P.O. Box 75782, Tampa, Florida 33675. And those are the ways of giving. As for announcements, I don't have many. As you know, we do have our midweek manna, which is on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. You can tune in via our Facebook channel or YouTube. Facebook is Light of the World Church, INC. And our YouTube channel is LOTWCINC. We also have our Sunday school at 9 a.m. for adults and children. We do have the meeting link and password on our Facebook. It is via Zoom, so if you'd like to attend Sunday school, again, we have Sunday school for the children and the adults. And again, that's 9 a.m. on Sunday mornings, followed by our Sunday morning worship at 11 a.m., which you can, again, tune in our Facebook and our YouTube channel. And as well, you can always come into the house of the Lord, where we do have the necessary items for you to be comfortable in the house of the Lord. We also have our prayer line, which is Mondays, Thursdays, and Fridays from 7:27 to 8 p.m. That prayer line number is 951-981-7249. Again, that's 951-981-7249. That's Mondays, Thursdays, and Friday nights from 7:27 to 8 p.m. And I think that is all that I have for the announcements. I do apologize if I missed any.
I'm struggling, I'm struggling, yeah. Trouble don't last always.
until God. Hallelujah. Praise God for your blessing on today. Amen. Hallelujah. Give us a round of applause for your blessing on today. Hallelujah. Amen. You gotta be happy because God said He loves a cheerful giver. Amen. When we give, we gotta be cheerful when we do it. Amen. Hallelujah. At this time, we're gonna take a little pause, right? And we're gonna do a little Black History program. The youth that we have, they're gonna give you a little bit of history on today. Amen. So you're gonna give your amens, your claps, and all the jumping for joy, you know, for the youth on today. They're gonna embark, and we're gonna have some older youth, they're gonna help participate also. Amen. Give you a little bit of history. Amen. We're gonna have our Black National Anthem by Sister Kylie Green. She's gonna come up and give us our Black National Anthem.
Amen.
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 Brother
agriculture, scientists, and inventors who developed hundreds of ways, hundreds of colors using peanuts, potatoes,
and
soybeans.
My character,
George Washington.
Amen.
Brother Jemiah Hunt.
Yeah. Woo!
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
How terrible. Bless you. A Civil War actor in 1926, Coleman was the first black woman to fly an airplane. When American Flight School denied her entrance to do her race, she taught herself French and moved to France, earning her license from Cadre School in just several months.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. First person to fly an airplane. Amen. Our next character will be Sister Kylie Green.
My character is Ruby Bridges. In 1954, at age 6, Ruby Bridges was the first African woman or student to attend a white school.
Amen. Ruby Bridges. Amen. That she's still alive today. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Next, we're going to have Sister Abby Petros. Jane Bowling. Amen? Amen. Our next one is going to have Sister Quintara Ingram. Today I'm not Sister Quintara. Today I am Serena Janika Williams. I am a tennis player. I was born in 1981. I emerged straight out of the streets of Compton to become the world's number one player. I have won 23 major single titles and the most by any man or woman in the open area. I am Serena Janika Williams. Amen. 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 Next we're going to have Brother Amnon Pedros.
I am Frederick Douglass Fritz Pollard, January 27, 1894. May 11, 1986 was an American football player. And he was the first African-American in Marshall in the National Football League NFL. Pollard and Bobby Marshall was the first two African-American players in NFL in 1984. 20, football pioneer Walter Camp called Pollard one of the greatest runners these eyes ever seen.
Amen. It's Pollard. Amen. Hallelujah. Then we're going to have Sister Trenise Pedro, so she's going to come up.
Benjamin Davis, 1880, he died 1970. Benjamin Davis was the first black general in American military. He served for 50 years as a temporary first lieutenant at an all-black unit during the Spanish-American War throughout his service.
Amen. The next thing we have is called, it's the Civil Rights of 1866, declare all males persons born in the United States to be citizens without destruction of race or color or previous condition of slavery. Amen. And the next one is one that people celebrate. It's what we call Juneteenth. But people say it is the oldest national celebration commemorative of the ending of slavery in the United States. Dated back in 1865, it was on June 19th that the date June 19th and June 13th enslaved African Americans in Galveston, Texas, where they were told, "We are free." Amen? So that's why we celebrate Juneteenth. Amen? Amen. We got one more, but we're going to have Minister Sampson come on up, and she's going to give us the poem. And then I'm gonna have everybody do this. We're missing two of them, but everybody can do this last one. Amen.
The name of my poem is I Am. I am strong. I am gentle. I am proud. I am humble. I am confident. I am beautiful. I am intelligent. I am becoming all that I can be. I am a child of God. And most of all, I am a black woman.
These are history, people that made history in life. Some we know, some we don't know. But those that we don't know, we continue to keep looking and see what they have done to make us free. Because anything that they've done to where we are today, it is very important. And it needs to be recognized that they have done a great work. Amen? Amen. At this point in time, we're going to get ready to introduce our speaker of the hour. But it looks like she has stepped out. So we're going to ask the musicians, will they give us a song until our speaker of the hour come on back in? Amen. As we present.
worship and praise, Father God. We have the authority, Father God, in your word to do this, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you keep us, Lord God, and you continue to keep us, Lord God. Bless each and every family that's represented here, Lord God. Bless each and every soul that's represented here, Lord God. Oh, God, bless the little children, Father God, as they learn, Father God, and continue to seek knowledge, Lord God. Oh, Heavenly Father, we would not take from your glory today, Lord God. Father God, but we do celebrate, Father God, you today, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, as I stand before you, Lord God, let there be no manifestation of the flesh today, Lord God. Let your Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide in this place, Lord God. We invoke your presence, Holy Spirit, in this house today, Lord God. We invoke your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Oh God, use this vessel, Father God. I use these gifts of people, Father God. Oh God, to articulate your word to your people, what you would have. Speak to my heart, Lord God. Speak to my heart, Lord God, that I may speak, Father God, for you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we give you the glory, honor, and the praises today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Give an honor to our apostle, our overseer today. I want to give honor to our pastor and his lovely wife, our overseer and his lovely wife, Evangelist Jones, our pastor, Timothy Brown, and his lovely wife, Sister Deidre, praise God, Minister Deidre, I should say. We want to give honor to our co-pastor, Evangelist Toronto Sampson and her family. I want to give honor to Deacons and prophetess that is not with us today, but we give honor to Prophet Smith and her husband. Praise the Lord, Deacon Smith. And I want to give honor, Lord God, to where honor is due to each and every one of us in this place today. Today we are commemorating our last week in February with the Black History. And so far, it has been we've had a lot of visitors in name that we have acknowledged in Black History. And I also came along today to bring, I brought some characters and some personalities with me also commemorating Black History. But we won't take away from God's book and we won't forget Jesus today, amen? Amen. Yes, as I find myself being invited to speak on the Black History Week, I thank you for the invitation. Yes, since we are in this final week, and this is the last week, I always appreciate the opportunity to familiarize myself with some leaders, some of the inventions that were made for some people, from some people, some of the inventions that were made from some of our great Americans, and the ones that, a lot of them that helped us and have kept us safe. We have to, you know, thank God for these people as we continue living every day and using a lot of these and products that they have made. Yeah, we have some great creators and innovators of our American history. A lot of these things made our lives easier. Look at me with the Black American who accumulated nearly 60 patents in his lifetime. He owned these patents. He owned the right to these patents, which spanned from 1856 to 1910. Granville T. Woods. His most notable one being the induction telegram system, which allowed the trains to communicate while other dispatches could find them. And also the first electric power rail, Granville Woods, one of our African-American inventors. We had one of them I heard mentioned here. Somebody already called his name today. Some of us have heard of George Washington Carver this morning. Yes, famous for giving us the peanut butter, bless his soul. It was a nice saying. A lot of us take pleasure in that peanut butter. But
He's responsible for so much more. As the agriculture chemist, Carver began conducting experiments in 1896 and created 518 new products from the crops of sweet potatoes and the peanuts, which included meat, dye, soap, cosmetics, flour, vinegar, synthetic rubber. He publicly revealed his experiments in 1914, and we thank him for his attribute, what he gave to us. We have the traffic light, which was patented in 1922 by Garrett Morgan. Saved a lot of lives by giving us the traffic lights. And this is just to commemorate some of the Black history. It was patented for his, breathing device, which was one of the earliest versions of the gas mask. We also have Peter Percy LeVon Jr., American chemist, made various contributions to modern medicine as a result of experiencing with soybean. And we're gonna bring in also Thomas Jennings from 1791 to 1859, was the first African-American person to receive the patent in the United States, paving the way for future inventors of color to gain exclusive rights to their own patents and their inventions. Amen. We also have this one person who was responsible for the ladies and for the hair and all the good-looking, you know, stuff that cosmetics and hair products. Madam C.J. Walker. A lot of us have heard of her. From 1867 to 1919, often referred to as America's first self-made female millionaire, daughter of Louisiana sharecroppers. In her early life, was full of hardship. By the age of 20, she was both orphaned and a widow. She joined with her brother in St. Louis, Missouri, where he was a barber. She suffered from hardship. She had a lot of problems in her health. She suffered from hair loss also, and experimented with various products, including hair care recipes developed by an African-American businesswoman named Annie Malone. Walker relocated to Denver, began selling her own products, and established beauty schools, salons, and training facilities across America. She died a millionaire, today considered to be one of the founders of African American hair products. We have now not as much is known about Alexander Miles, 1838 through 1918. He is known to have designed an important safety device for elevators, the automatic door. George Crumb is said to have unintentionally made the potato chip. In 1853, a favorite snack that a lot of us like. The refrigerated truck by Frederick McKinley Jones in 1940. So we have a lot of history for African America. The electric microphone converted by James E. West, 1964. Now Thomas Edison was another different person that created the light bulb, but we have an African-American brother that came along with the carbon light bulb, Louis Vandermeer, 1881. The innovation used to create longer lasting light. The color IBM PC monitors was co-invented by Mark Dean, 1890. through 1999. So the origin of the Black, History Month, or the story of Black History Month, began in 1915, half a century after the 13th Amendment abolished slavery in the United States. Amen. That was the Black history that I brought today. So now, before that, in history, we had another man that gave us freedom also.
All right.
Amen. And a lot of people still today don't know that he gave them freedom.
All right.
We have to know that we know who he is. We're in pursuit of him daily. Who he is and what it matters. Amen? Mm-hmm. He asked you a question. Who am I? If we ask enough people who he is, Jesus that is, you will certainly receive a variety of answers across the board of stipulations, speculations, of whatever somebody may want to think out of their own mind. The answers people give are conditioned to everyday living, conditioned to the life and the everyday forms of the world, by worldwide thinking.
Okay.
Amen. The thinking to the person's experience. What mama said, what daddy talking, what I learned in school, what I learned in the backyard. Whatever they experience, this is what they're thinking. But this is nothing new. People think all kinds of ways of who Jesus is. People have been debating and arguing the identity and significance of Jesus since he lived on the earth. What is written about him and what he did and what he said created controversy. It pushes people to deal with him. He is not one that can be ignored. Amen? People have always had different responses to him. By looking at the response of those that were near him and those that walked with him, that were close to him, by looking at their responses and those that really knew him, we can understand our own reaction and the reaction of others. Amen? Here in Matthew, the 16th chapter, if you want to go there with me, you can. Matthew 16, 13, and 14. But I'm going to tell you before we read that, that before that, we had the 4,000 people that Jesus had fed. We had the 4,000 people that, the 4,000 men that he had fed, not even counting the women and children. 4,000 men that he fed, and fed the people, and after he fed the people, we had Pharisees that came and wanted to question him and wanted to ask him all kind of crazy stuff, and he wanted to know about, you know, what significant it was that sets the presence for where he's at now. Matthew 16 and 13, Jesus took his disciples away from the crowd. Verse 13 said, "Howbeit, when the Spirit of truth is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall be spake, and will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and shall show it unto you." Jesus, I think I'm a little off. Let's go to Matthew. That was supposed to be in Matthew. I'm sorry, Matthew 16. But that will flow right into what I'm talking about. Matthew 16 and 13. When Jesus came to the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" Who do you say he is? Amen?
Amen?
So let us address the question to his disciples. Who am I? Who do they say that I am? Men say that I, the Son of Man, am. Some say that thou art John the Baptist. Some say Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. But he said to them, but who do ye say that I am? Here he's using this word, who do you say? He's speaking to plural to all of them. Amen. These Jewish prophets that they mentioned all contributed something to the life of the Israelites. But he said to Simon Peter, when Simon Peter answered, Simon Peter said, you are the Messiah. And Peter's name that he gave him was a stone.
Yeah.
He said, on this rock I shall build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. This was a confused situation for the Pharisees. The Pharisees, Jesus said to them, you discern the sun, you discern the day, you discern this, and you discern that. But you can't discern who you're talking to. You cannot discern who's walking in the midst of you, amongst you. You can't discern the truth. So while Jesus walking and leaving them and taking his disciples away, we come to the place where the disciples all agreed, and it wasn't an answer just from Peter himself, because Jesus said to Peter, upon this rock, and the rock meaning his church, meaning the soul of the people that are coming to him. He said, we are on the rock and we're on the solid foundation. This is what we're on, the rock of Jesus. He is the one. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, let's look at the confused part of it. To say he was confused, we have John the Baptist. John the Baptist, who baptized Jesus. They say that he was John the Baptist. If he could not be John the Baptist, John the Baptist and Jesus' ministry went parallel together. John baptized Jesus when unconscious John was in the belly of his mother. Unconscious John identified with the conscious Spirit of God in Mary. When unconscious John leaped in the belly of his mother, the conscious Spirit of God identified with the unconscious baby in the belly of Elizabeth. So now we go on, and John the Baptist and Jesus parallel ministry, walking together, Jesus baptizing him, speaking of, you know, each other. John the Baptist saying, the one that takes, blessed is the one that takes away the sin of the world. I am not able to stand before him and take unless you choose. Jesus came to John, asked John, told John that John had to baptize him. So Jesus and John the Baptist could not be the same person. They had a similarity, but it's impossible. They preached the same thing. They were the same age. They stood in the river together. John baptized him. They say he was Elijah. Elijah was expected to return to minister to the people of Israel before the day of the Lord, which included the coming of the Messiah. But they were wrong for that. They called him Jeremiah, one of the prophets. Israel had a long time history with prophets. Amen. Speaking to them since her beginning as a nation. Prophets had been a part of Israel's experience. So the disciples knew what the people were saying. When Jesus said, what, asking them, what were they saying? What, who did they think he was? They knew the people. They lived around the people. They walked around the people. They were in and out interacting with the people. They were not isolated or insulated away from, they were not an isolated or insulated group. They were obviously around the people a lot. So they all had various opinions of him, who he was. This is still the case today. People don't know who he is. This is still the case today. They're still trying to figure Jesus out. This is still the case today. That people go to church in and out of church there, all over the place, talking about Jesus, 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 but they don't really know him. They don't really know him in the spirit. They don't really know him in the truth. They don't really know him who They brought all the sick and all the hurting people. They brought them to Jesus, laid him at his feet, and he healed them. And every time he went in, Capernaum, Philadelphia, wherever he went at, wherever he stopped at, they brought people. John was confused about it. He knew that Jesus was healing the people. He knew that Jesus was who he said he was. But John got confused because he found himself in jail. John found himself in jail, and he's like, everybody getting their blessings, everybody getting their miracles, everybody getting healed, everybody getting this and getting that. Why am I in jail? And I'm his witness. I am his forerunner. Why I'm sitting up, why I can't be sanctified and saved away from this here? But God had a plan, amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. John was confused. He asked that fundamental question. He sent his disciples to ask this question. His mind, this question that formed in his mind, a question that needed to be answered, a question that needed to be known. Are you the one, or should we expect another? His confidence had devolved into a question of confusion. John had went into some type of sober depression or something, and he's sitting there wondering, why can't I be delivered from this? John couldn't understand that this was a sign of the time. John didn't understand that he shortly, not too long, because Jesus was in his 31, 2, 3, 30, his few years of ministry. And John and his finished up his ministry that he foreran to do. Not understanding that he and Jesus was going to be fellowshipping with the Father shortly. Amen. Now, we have the skeptic. That was the confused John. We have the skeptic. His homeboys in Nazareth. They said, where did he get this wisdom from? Where did he get this miracle working power from? These homeboys who he grew up with. These homeboys who he ran the street with, played in the yard with. John the carpenter's son, Mary's baby. James' brother, Joseph's brother, Simon's brother, Judah's brother, and those are sisters he had. We know him. Who do he think he is? Here in Nazareth, talk about he is the Messiah. He is the King of the Jews. He is working his miracles. Where do he think he gets his power from? Where did he get it from? These are the skeptics watching him. They try to figure it out. So because of them, in Nazareth, in his hometown, he could not do no miracles. He couldn't do anything. If he touched and healed one or two people, that was it. He couldn't do anything in his own town because of those skeptics that knew him, that grew up with him, those that knew him, those that saw his life, those that saw what he did, those that saw where he went, those that saw who he hung out with, those that saw him growing up. They wouldn't receive him because they were skeptic. Amen? So we have the antagonists. Now, this is history. This is history for us because this is like the black history that we are learning in our schools and teaching our children. This is a history that needs to be taught more so, amen? Amen. We have the antagonists. Now, they wanted to kill him. They wanted to get rid of him.
Well,
after seeing and hearing all the work that he had done, they wanted him dead. They wanted him dead. He was at least nothing by appearance. He was not threatening at all. He was the least, he was not going to hurt or harm anybody. He just looked like that. But he was a threat, especially in the eyes of the Sanhedrins, the ruling group over Judah, over the Jewish people, the religious leaders, the Pharisees and the Sadducees. To them, Jesus was more than a nuisance. Jesus was putting the mere existence of the Jewish people in trouble, in perils. They thought if they let him go on doing miracles, going on talking about his kingdom, they let him go on and heal people and deliver people. They thought that if he went on like this, the people would start believing him. And then the Roman soldiers will come and take both the temple and the nation because of his miracles. They will come and occupy the space. They will come and occupy there where they were. Roman will see him and Israel as a threat to revolt against their control over the Jewish people. A threat like this would result into not just military occupation, but active domination and destruction, or perhaps extermination.
Uh-huh.
Glory to God. So, to choose to act in what they thought was best for the Jewish people, they choose to kill him, bring him before a judge, and find him guilty. We must find today our choice.
Yeah.
We must choose today
uh-huh.
who he is. He is a threat to your means, and he's a threat to your identity and your security if you will not let him in. In other words, you won't let him in your business.
Yeah.
Are you finding ways to keep him out? Now, we have the curious. We're gonna get to the curious now. So what is the truth? We have the curious that are curious about, they don't know if they would be antagonists or skeptics or what they're curious. Curiosity is a fundamental question everyone asks at some time or some point or another.
Yeah.
Your objective or subjective view, your mere judgment or your mere opinion of truth. It shapes our interpretation of life. It may be that this question has significance in current decisions, and this question isn't bound exclusively to us. And before, in the presence of Pilate, it has significant implications for all of us. Pilate asking the question, Jesus and Pilate face to face, regarding one another. Pilate, the one that has the eternal official, he has the earthly official authority. He made this happen. He made that happen. He made anything happen he wanted to happen. Pilate made it happen in his jurisdiction. He held life and death in his jurisdiction. That's why they brought Jesus to him. Pilate the judge, Jesus the accused was, this is the curious, okay? This was a trial. This hearing revolved around one question. Are you the king of the Jews? The answer determines the outcome. Jesus' answer determines the outcome. My kingdom, he says, is not of this world. Glory to God. My kingdom is not of this world. It's the fastest court case in history. Open and shut. Pilate had no clue of what he was talking about. Not of this world. Pilate thinking this man must be schizophrenic or something. He says his kingdom is not of the world. He claimed a kingdom that was not natural, right? And before Pilate, where he could see the people, his followers. And claiming kingship is a sedition against Rome. Pilate says, I find no basis. I can't find charges, man, with nothing. He said his kingdom is not of this world. Where is his kingdom? Where are his people? Who are his followers? I can't find no claim against this man. So what do you say? What do we say? Who do you say Jesus is?
All right.
He asked his closest friends, who do you say that I am? Peter said the first answer to respond, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. Did all the people believe this? Did his followers, those that were with him, believe this? Perhaps. It's impossible for them not to believe it, seeing the miracles. Glory to God. It's impossible. It's impossible they didn't receive him for the things that they saw him do. but it was inspired by God, the answer to Peter. What's important is that Jesus affirmed the answer is true to Pilate. He was indeed the Messiah. Jesus wanted to know, not because of his self-perception or his self-worth, what the people's opinions were, but Jesus presented the question that needed to be answered. People have responded in various ways. Confused, skeptic, antagonist, curious. These responses continue today because still, and they are still necessary today. Who do you say that Jesus is? The question filters its way through time, even today, to everyone, every culture. Everyone has to answer the point, this question at some point or another. Who do you say he is?
Okay.
How do you perceive him?
Amen.
I see Jesus.
Uh-huh.
I perceive him. I'll tell you how I perceive him. I know a lot of people say I see him as my bridge over troubled water.
Uh-huh.
I see him as my burden bearer.
Uh-huh.
I see him as my father. I see him as my bread when I'm hungry. I see him as my water when I'm thirsty. I look back and I see him as my deliverer. I see him as my self-savior. I see him as my salvation. Hallelujah. I see him as my promise keeper. Hallelujah. I see him as the faithful Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He shows up with abundant mercies. I see him in manifestation of everything that I need whenever I pray and ask him to help me. He manifests himself. I have testimony after testimony where everything that good that has happened to me, the Lord did it. He woke me up this morning. That's who he is to me. He guided me on my way. That's what he is to me. Keep me clothed in my right mind. That's who he is to me. He's my compassionate father. Hallelujah. That's who he is. Glory to God. He loved me. He compromises a lot of things for me. He fixes everything that I need. Because I can't find nobody. I look and I can't find nobody. I search and I can't find nobody. He embraces those that are going the way. He brings them back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He's a great provider. Hallelujah. Talk to him. They might not have that confidence to believe him and know that he is who he said he is.
Let them receive Jesus right now. Let them receive Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, bless the souls, Lord God, that need to know, Father God, you and the pardoning of their sins, to know you as their Father, to know you, Lord God, as their leader and their guider, their sanctifier, Lord, their deliverer, Lord God. Bless them right now, Lord God. Have mercy on your people, Lord God, those that I most need of your mercy, Lord. Lord, reach out to the hospitals, Lord God, the jails, Lord God, the prisons, Lord God, the streets, Lord God, the nursing homes, Lord God, all of these places where people want to come to you, they can't come, Lord God. There are a lot of them right now that will fill up the church, Lord God, if they were allowed to or able to, Lord God. Bless them, Lord God. Bless us as we leave, Father God, this place to go home today, Lord God. Bless us, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for all of your blessings that you have already bestowed on us, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We magnify you, Lord. We glorify you, Lord God. We give you the honor, Lord. We give you the praise, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. Oh, God, we thank you in sincerity, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, because you know this is just a sincerity, Lord God, to know where we are in you, Lord God. Oh, we worship you and magnify you, Lord God. Holy, thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Really, thank God for everybody. Thank God for the thing that's worthy. Amen. Knowing a long time ago. Amen. I was healed from the Lord a long time, preaching the gospel. Amen. I remember when they were young. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
And be everywhere. I'm Pastor Newberry. Pastor Bonnie Hill. Amen. And be everywhere preaching the gospel. Get people saved, delivered, and set free. Thank God for she still has the mind.
Yes.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Still has the mind. Amen to serve the Lord. Let us say praise God.
Amen.
I thank God. Amen for the mind that I have. Amen. Amen to serve God. Now, don't think that I ain't been here. I'm not asleep. I'm still asleep.
Amen.
I'm still filled with the Holy Ghost. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Amen. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I hadn't lost anything.
Amen.
And I thank God for being here. Amen. I said, this is your prayer that you pray for us. I pray for my granddaughter and pray for my sister. Amen. If you want to have issues, pray for them. Amen. I want you to pray especially for my aunt. She's 90 years old. I'm saying that only the last of my mother. Amen. And she's been ill, been eating. God bless her. Eat and pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Able to eat food. Eat to put in amen. God bless you. He even took two of them.
Yes.
Bless you.
Thank the Lord.
Amen. Thank God for that. Right. Amen. God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Pray for my wife also.
Amen. Glory to God. I just want to make one announcement that was not made because I had gave to her just to let everyone know that on March the 26th, we ought to be at New Zion Pentecostal Church with none other than Pastor Campbell at 7 p.m. is the church anniversary, and I believe that Life in the World Church will be in charge of the services. So keep your calendars clear, praise team. Glory to God, that's going to be on a Friday. So it's March the 26th, Friday, March the 26th. At 7 p.m. And glory to God, we are in charge of the services. The Lutheran women in charge of the service. We do praise and worship. So please keep that announcement in mind. We will be continue to announce that. And we're looking for everyone who's able to go to please go. Because like I said, we're in charge of the service. So again, it's going to be March 26th. 7 p.m. on a Friday night. Amen?
Amen.
Also, glory to God, I stuff in the back for the kids. I'm on. Amen. And at this time, praise God, before we pray, our pastor, praise God, is there any other announcement, any other sayings? Don't want to leave any of y'all. Glory to God, glory to God.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord. I have a testimony and a request. I want you all to keep me in your prayers. You know I'm always evangelizing. I always talk with somebody, Sister Mary, Sister Emma, when she's on the Lord, then she go talking and it be about the Lord.
Amen.
I have a desire. Expressing this desire
international
ministry, and I was speaking to somebody over in Cali, Colombia about being associated with the church down there. Whenever I go there, that I can meet the pastor, and the next time I go and fellowship with them from here while I'm here now. And it was a weekend that I was talking about it, and a few days later, about 3 days later, somebody called me and asked me if I had a burning desire to go to another country and minister, share my testimony, and minister to some people in jail.
Amen.
I said, absolutely. She said, well, then we're going on April the 9th. I said, put me on the flight.
Amen.
So I'm launching out to international ministry.
Amen.
And it's only by the desire of God. Because I'm always, going somewhere, and I love to share the word. I love to talk. talk to people and I love to share my testimony. And God has opened the avenue. He's opened the door for me to do international ministry. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Keep me in your prayers. Glory to God. Won't he do it? Hallelujah. He said that I give you the desires of your heart. Say, mine, stay on me. Glory to God. He said, meditate on me day and night, and I shall give you the desires of your heart. Glory to God. I tell you, the word is true. At this time, he has said, everyone will stand. Glory to God has been granted.
Before we dismiss, we want to give them the opportunity to still do their Black History part. It was running a little bit late, but we're going to ask them to come on up so they can do their part. That's Brother Mario and Brother Jay Juno.
Jano.
They're going to come on up and they're going to do their last part. They're supposed to do for Black History.
All right. Y'all have a seat. If we have to do that part again. Glory to God.
not alive. You know, some people don't, amen, or be somewhere else on their birthday. Ain't that right? But we praise God for her, amen. Brother Tony, amen, being and the children being in the house of worship on today. Amen. Giving God some praise. Ain't that right? Amen. Amen. The songwriter says, when the praises go up, amen, the blessings come down. Amen. So we praise God again. Amen. For you joining, amen, us on today. I want you to keep watching, amen, on our YouTube channel. Amen. So blessed to be with God. And also continue, amen, to call the prayer line. Somebody say, call the prayer line. Amen. The prayer line, glory to God, is what, Mondays? All right. Thursdays and Fridays. Amen. Hallelujah. We want you to call, amen, the prayer line for God. Amen. Has a miracle. Somebody say a miracle in store for you. Come on, say it one more time. A miracle. Amen. In store. Amen. For you. Miracle in store. Amen. For you. Glory be to God. And that prayer line number is 951-981-7249. Again, that's 951, amen, 981-7249. Amen. How many know if there ever was a time, amen, to pray, the time is now. Isn't that right? And the Bible tells us that we should always pray and not faint. Isn't that right? And so we bless God. Amen. There'll be no more announcements today. There'll be no more sayings today. Amen. The woman of God is coming back. Amen. Hallelujah. Evangelist Murphy, you have anything to say? Amen. On today.